Okay, so if you're using Google Sheets, you may have two different tables that you want to combine together, but those tables don't necessarily have the same column headers and the same type of data in them. But as long as you have something in common between the two tables, you can merge them together, and that's what we're going to do right now. All right, so the scenario that we're going to walk through is that you work at a company, you're in the accounting department, so we have this blank table here that we're going to try to fill up, and we need to combine the information from human resources. So the table on the left has employee IDs, and that's what we're going to use because those are in both tables. And it also has the number of vacation hours that they didn't use, let's say at the end of December. You need to take those vacation hours, but you need to multiply them by the pay rate. And then we're going to pull in the department too. That information's in this different table. These tables have different headers and different numbers of people in them. So let's come over to the accounting. What we want to end up with is a list just with these names, because these are the only people that we are saying have accrued vacation right here. And we're going to bring them into this table to the right. So the first thing we want to do, let's do employee ID. That's kind of the key, if you will, between these two tables, because it's the same in both. And since this is going to be the same number of rows from the table that we want to pull it from, so we want to pull it from this table. And we're just going to bring it in the same order. All you really need to do for this first action is just to hit your equals key and do a cell reference. So we want to pull this from B6. Left click on it with your mouse, hit enter, and you've pulled the first one over already. So there's nothing tricky at this point. Let's pull this all the way down. So go in the lower right hand corner of the cell, left click the mouse button, pull it down. All right, so we're moving along already. We have the employee ID, and the next one is actually the same thing too. So we'll go through that a little bit faster. Everything's still in the same order, employee ID and hours. But now things get a little bit trickier. So the dollars per hour has to come from this other table. There is the employee ID in common, so that's what we're going to use. But you have to use a function called VLOOKUP, and it just stands for vertical lookup. And you do that by saying, hey, look up the ID 26988 in this table. So look down for 26988. When you find it, we're going to say go one to the right and return what's there. So we're looking to return 1899 in this case. So let's go into cell M6 and we're going to type VLOOKUP. Start your parentheses and it will give you some help. It's asking for the search key, which is just what you're using to look up the value in the other table. So that's K6. And then it wants to know the range. So we're going to not select the headers. We're going to select the data in this table because that's where you want to look for it. But you'll notice that I'm not selecting the department. I selected the data so that the key that we have in common is all the way to the left, and then the rest of the data is to the right. So I only needed these two columns. Another thing you have to remember, I would press your F4 key right now to fix this table. So when you drag your VLOOKUP down into row 7, 8, 9, etc., that table range stays the same. So that's called a fixed reference. And if you wanted to type it in, you would just add these dollar signs that you see in the formula. The next parameter that VLOOKUP needs is the index, which just means what's the column number. So the employee ID is in column 1, right? And the pay per hour is in column 2. So you don't say H and I, which are the letters. You say 1 is the first one, but we want 2. So you're counting from the left to the right. The next parameter that needs is it sorted? That's asking if the list that I'm using to look it up in, so the range from H to I, is that sorted? The answer is no, so we're going to say false. And then let's close off the function. We were looking for 1899, and that's what happened. So the VLOOKUP looked up employee ID 26988, went to the second column, 1899, and returned that. So let's drag this formula down. And let's look up 38324, that's 3287, so you know this formula is working. If you get a pound NA error in here, it means that you're trying to look up something that's not in this table. So I'll link to a video about how to deal with that error, but it's basically telling you, I tried to look it up and there's nothing there. Our next column in this case is just a multiplication. So we're going to multiply the hours times the rate. That one's easy. Hopefully you can get through that one. Drag that down. But then the last thing that we're going to do is we want to look up the department. But when you do the VLOOKUP, so let's start it. You know what the search key is, so let's select that. That's okay so far. So the problem that you run into now is that the value that you need to look up should be in the leftmost column, and then you need to look to the right to find what you're going to return. But in this case, the value that we want to look up is in the middle, and then we want to return the department. So what you do here is you kind of trick Google Sheets a little bit. You feed it the range in a way that will shift the employee ID, in this case, column H, to the left. So what we want to do, you want to start out this range with a curly brace, which is telling Google Sheets this is an array, not just a regular range, right? And then we're going to specify H and I first. You can hit your dollar sign to fix it. And then use a comma and maybe a semicolon if you're in a country that uses commas for decimal separators, but we're going to use a comma. And then select column G as your next column. Fix that with an F4. And then in the curly braces. So what you've done here is you've given Google Sheets these ranges in a way that it makes column H the first column, then I, then column G. So you're going to be able to look through this from the left to the right because you took the columns and you rearranged them. And then it wants the index number. So we're going to return the third column. And our data is still not in order, so we'll end it with a false. Close it off with the parentheses, hit enter. And let's see, I think that one worked, 26988. Let's look over here, 26988 is production. Pull this down to copy it, and there we go. So we've pulled in data from a table using VLOOKUP, but looking to the left instead of to the right. So we've put that table together now. Your next step might be to sum the data based on the department. A really quick and easy way to do that would be to make a pivot table, and this next video is going to show you how you would do that. Thanks for watching, and if you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe.